lives and works in Mumbai. And he's also, you know, voted us, awarded us, you know, Rolls Royce of Artist of the Year. Rolls Royce, the company, they commissioned his project. And that's the kind of award. He invited 97 artists from 31 countries. And this Biennale runs in, as I mentioned, 108 days in 12 venues. This is the first venue where you entered. It's the largest venue. Every venue is important for us. And there are also, in this Biennale, you could find artists, writers, filmmakers, new media artists, musicians, performers, theatre people, all an architect. You know, for example, one of the architects of project, you know, last and previous Biennale, we had the talk pavilion here. You know, we created temporary pavilion for talks and performance, etc. So this year we have a temporary pavilion. Next door it's a place called Cabralia. You can only 1 minute walking distance, and you can see, you know, it's 12 venues are spread out in four locations, four cityscapes. One is in Fort Kochi and Mattancheri, and the third is in Ernakulam, and the fourth is in Muziris area, which is 1.5 hour travel from here. So I would suggest that you do see these 11 venues at least before you leave. And as architect students, it is one of the most interesting places to walk around. Even the streets are historically very interesting. More than 33 different kind of community lives in this area. So the characteristic of this area is very interesting. And also more than 13 different kind of languages people speak. It's an ideal location for a Biennale. So we are trying to show contemporary art. When I was studying in Bombay, there was no option for you to see contemporary art. I was studying in JJ. We had one side architecture college, one side applied art and the fine arts and building technology, etc. But what was interesting for me to go to Delhi for the Biennale. First, the Biennale was started by India in 1968. In 2005 onwards, we don't have anything as such. So many people, many students get an opportunity to see contemporary art practices from around the world. So Kochi-Biennale gives an opportunity for seeing original practices, how people are thinking, how curators are working, all that kind of thought. You can see it in this project. Do you have any questions? I would suggest that, you know, like, since you are, you know, like, in this Biennale, there are architecture biennial, there are a lot of architectural elements, architectural materials, mediums are all used by our, you know, this is like an organically built place. I mean, most of the installations are made by artists. You see that we are looking at the site, after looking at the site, the conversations in between the curator and the artist and the Biennale Foundation, taken care of all the production of all the works and showed all the works, traveled from different parts of the world. So you can see different kinds of thoughts and things like that. It's not about painting or sculpture. It is about all life itself, I would say. And also you could see some of the projects. It's a kind of ongoing project, like 108 days we have it. It's like you know, one of the rooms there, and there's some mural artists, the traditional artists, working with his assistants. So you could see the process of making art. Some of the rooms you can find some artists will be working in. Pradeep Soy is one of the artists. He lives and works in Amsterdam, but he is here for 108 days. Things like that you could see in another venue chapter. The scale of the work is also varied. Some works are very small, but some works are really big in scale. So for architecture students and designers, there are a lot of interesting things to know from this Biennale. And if you are interested in the short guide, it's available in the shop. And good luck for your...